Welcome to the first video of Minecraft Skyblock here on PvP Wars. The server just reset about 24 hours ago, a little over that, but the point is it's a brand new reset and I can't wait to get started. If you guys are gonna come and check out the server, make sure to use my custom IP on screen, nc.pvpwars.net. The first thing I recommend when hopping on Skyblock is to go to this NPC, the tutorial NPC, and go through all the tutorial stuff because you'll get a lot of free loot. As well, if you do /streak, you can get your daily streak, which gives you a ton of good rewards, a ton of crate keys for free for logging on the server every day. The loot gets better and better over time. But if I go on PV1, I did all the tutorial stuff and I got a ton of cool items I do want to go ahead and go over. We got some spawners we'll probably use at some point. We got a kit that I probably don't need, but we got some XP vouchers. But I'm going to claim this farming XP voucher. I don't know if that was good or not. We'll do it with the mining, and we got to level 3 on our mining skill, because what these do is basically upgrade our skills. We'll go ahead and do the combat one as well. If we go ahead and type /skills, you can see there's a ton of different skills. So far in mining, if I take a look, we have a decent bit of loot from here. We got a rare orb, but I don't know what that does. Let's go ahead and take a look. Oh, it's an enchant orb. That's pretty interesting. And then we got some XP we'll claim. How much XP do we have? Oh, we have 125,000. Wow. We got a basic orb. We'll go in PV12 and put away the enchants. And we got a crystal key, what is a pretty good key. I'm also going to go ahead and turn off my toggles. And I'm going to disable a few things. I'm going to toggle off the quest navigation because I don't need it currently. Scoreboard time, I think I'll toggle off, and we'll get rid of the item in our inventory that's taking up the 9th slot. Okay, we should be good for now. But anyways, we have a ton of crate keys we need to go ahead and open. I believe we have 6 votes, what we can get a ton of good loot to start out with, a ton of money, mob coins, and all sorts of good loot. So we'll go ahead, open up the vote. We got 1,000 emerald mob coins, what is pretty good. An infinite player shop, 100,000 in money, what's not bad. 1,000,000 XP, 200K in cash, and another 150K in cash. What isn't too bad? We go ahead, go into the void crates. We got 2,000 emerald mob coins, a water wand, a glitch kit, a self money booster, another one, and money. Perfect. And then we're gonna go ahead, go to the crystal crate, open this up. We got a watering pot for seeds, what are custom seeds on the server. So we'll probably use that at some point. And we also have pet candy, what I'll save for now. We also did get a tutorial pickaxe, which is pretty decent. But I wanna see if Kit Glitch, the top rank, is better than the actual pickaxe that is given here. It is indeed better by a long shot. We're gonna go into PV, I believe, 12, and we're gonna go ahead, put away some of this stuff that we, of course, do not need for now. We got all our tools and our armor we'll go ahead and put on, and there we go. We are situated with all our tools and whatnot. There's quests on the server that we're gonna save for a different time, but quests give you a ton of free loot just by doing them, so we'll do that at some point. But now the moment of truth, we gotta create our island. So /is, and we're gonna do the original island template, which should give us a small island and our cobble cube, or tower gen, I should say. Because back when I played this server years ago, this used to be called the cobble cube, so that's why I called it that. But it is actually now a tower gen. Tower gens, you can go ahead and upgrade and actually get better storage and loot within this. It's pretty OP when it gets to a higher level, but I don't need to upgrade it for now. If we take a look in shop, I want to see how much an axolotl's worth. 900,000, so we almost have enough to buy another. What I probably won't buy, but we have 3 of them, so easily we have 2.7 million worth of spawners already, just in like raw money. But I think I do want to go ahead and start building a little spawner farm. I think what we'll do is use some deep slate brick as well as polished deep slate. So we'll get the polished bit of deep slate, we'll get 4 stacks, and we're going to use it wisely to build a little area for our axolotl. Get it to a stack, and we'll buy 4 stacks of that. And that right there was like 50,000 or something almost, put into just blocks. Anyways, the point is we're going to build a axolotl farm just to start off, so we can make some income. And I think what the plan is, we're gonna make it manual for now. So we'll just make a simple old axolotl farm. So I think we're gonna make the floor out of bricks right here. And we're gonna have to start destroying stuff. I'm gonna tear down this island because I would like to move everything around, as well as the tower gen, because we can move it. So we'll go ahead and get sorted with all the area of our island. We have 2 pieces of bedrock for some reason. What I mean is fine, just kind of weird. Okay, so now if I go to island go, it should be right on this block. So here's what I'm gonna gonna do. I think I can adjust where my player spawns at, so we don't have to show this bedrock anywhere except for when we're flying around. But we'll make some slabs, go like that, and then we'll build around and see if this looks good. So if I go to island go, we should be right at the center here. So there we go. That's our island spawn point that we'll spawn at every time, what is pretty decent. So I built a little platform. I'll probably decorate it over time, but I'll probably get an admin to remove this one piece of bedrock because it's kind of in the way. And I would like to just not have it there just so we can make the island look nice. I'll go ahead and use PV2 for now for my spare blocks that I'll use for designing. And I think I'll move the tower gen to the back over here. And that's where the tower gen will go. Now we'll make our little axolotl farm right in the front here. So right when we come to the island, we will see the axolotl farm. So I'm gonna go out 5 blocks, go out 1, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Do it on the sides as well. I'm gonna buy some more stone brick because we're gonna need it. I'm gonna buy another stack of stone brick. So now I'm gonna build the axolotl farm. So we need a trap door. Let's go ahead and buy a singular trap door, and we're gonna put it right here. And then we'll put a slab right here, and we're gonna put some on the outside as well. Now the reason we need the slabs is so we'll shift under it and then start attacking the axolotl. And we're also gonna get a singular water bucket, and the reason for that is because if we waterlog this, the axolotl won't die and it'll stack up over time. It's pretty convenient. Okay, so now this right here is gonna be where the water platform is gonna go. I'm also gonna redecorate this a little bit, just make it look similar to the floor pattern. Is there polished slabs? Yes, there is. Perfect. So if I'm not mistaken, I go out about this far and the corner would be right here where I place the water bucket, and then we put it in all the corners. And eventually if we make like a blaze farm or something that is a mob that we can use this farm for, we'll use it, or we'll demolish this if we need to. Okay, so we place the water down and it should not flow in there. Perfect. And we do that in each corner. Then we'll go up 3 blocks, have the spawner here, and then the block will be right there. And I guess we'll put 3 blocks tall just in case. I don't know, just to be safe. Grab out our axolotls, place it down. Okay, so one of my axolotl spawners disappeared. I literally have no clue where it went. I'm pretty sure breaking it does not get rid of the spawner, but I lost one of them. I don't really know how, but I mean, we're just gonna go ahead, stack this in, and I guess we'll deal with it. It's not the end of the world. I'm gonna replace the pillar with, I believe, 3 glowstone. It should be good. I'm still really confused about that axolotl. Kind of annoying that we lost the spawner. Let's go into PV2, put away our blocks that we have here. And if I need spare buckets, I'll put those in there as well. So now if I go ahead, shift, go under here, we can now kill axolotls and get XP in the chat from an XP booster that's currently active. As well, we can also get mob coins, the gold ones. If we go ahead and do mob coin space shop, we can actually see the information of what mobs give what mob coins. So if we want emerald mob coins, we can actually go and kill iron golems, zombified piglins, and snowmen. And if we want gold, we can kill all types of other mobs. It's basically the whole system. And we also get frog spawn. With the looting 5, we make even more frog spawn. But I'm kind of curious, how much does it sell for per one? Let's go to mob loot, take a look at the frog spawn. 0.5 per one. So if I were to do a sell all, that's only $116 there. What isn't too great, but I mean, it's better than nothing. And one thing we can go ahead and do with the XP is use it in the XP shop. If I need to buy anything with XP, we'll probably buy it from here. With some of our money, I think we're gonna go ahead and upgrade the tower gen before we call it wraps. So we'll go ahead and go into the loot upgrade, and we'll go ahead and start upgrading this. And now if we go ahead and upgrade to level 6, we get copper, and then we'll keep leveling it up. And now we can get lapis. And I don't think we'll go for 16 because I don't think we can afford all the way to 16. And I'd like to do at least all the way to the emerald each time. But there we go. We have everything situated for now on the island. I can't wait to keep progressing even more.